Hi, I'm Dr. Mark Trolice, Medical Director of Fertility CARE, the IVF Center here in Orlando, Florida. I wanted to spend some time talking with you all about a study that came out last week, and it caused a lot of news and concern among women and confusion because it had to do with ovarian age testing. Now, a lot of you know about FSH levels, and probably most of you are getting more familiar with anti-mullerian hormone, or AMH. So let's just do a little bit of background about those two hormone tests, okay? And then we're going to talk about this study that is looking at whether AMH or FSH can actually prove and predict your fertility. So FSH, the gold standard for many, many years of ovarian age testing. FSH is a pituitary hormone, and it is used to stimulate the follicle that's going to develop the egg and ovulate that month. So the higher the level of FSH early in a menstrual cycle, usually we measure it on menstrual cycle day 2, 3, or 4, and the higher level, the lower the numbers of eggs. It's indirectly being fed back by the ovary, and it's getting a measure of the numbers of eggs. FSH is not a very reliable test, though. It can fluctuate month to month. There's a lot of variability. So if it's elevated, we know that there's ovarian aging. If it's not, we don't know. It just may not have been elevated that month. So not a great test, very limited because it has to be done at a certain day in the menstrual cycle. And it also has a lot of false negatives, meaning that if the level is normal, it could still be ovarian aging and we just didn't detect it that month. Let's switch over to anti-mullerian hormone. This is the test that we use here exclusively, and most reproductive centers are finishing up with FSH and not using them for quite some time now. So AMH is a hormone produced in the cells surrounding the egg. Thereby, the lower numbers of eggs, the lower the anti-mullerian hormone, and more ovarian aging. The question is, what do they really reflect? Can they predict fertility? Well, this study in the Journal of the American Medical Association released last week from Raleigh, North Carolina, looked at women between age 30 and 44. And they looked at those that had abnormal AMH and FSH, so FSH elevations or AMH low, and compared them to women of the same age that had normal levels, and looked at whether it was able to predict their fertility in terms of pregnancy rates, and there was no difference. There was no difference in the pregnancy rate between women between the ages of 30 and 44, whether they had a low AMH or a normal FSH, AMH, or a high FSH or a normal FSH. Now, certain caveats though, okay? They did not include any fertility problems in the man or the woman. Okay, there could have been, but they didn't include those patients, so that could be effective. They did not include patients who had subsequent use of fertility medication. We actually didn't know if they did, so we call that censored. We did not know if that was included. And the another caveat of this test is that the pregnancy tests were just the positive pregnancy tests. It didn't talk about ongoing pregnancies or live birth. We don't know if low AMH or high FSH would have resulted in a higher rate of miscarriage. The bottom line is that unless you've been trying for adequate time to conceive, I think getting AMH levels and certainly FSH levels are premature, okay? And second is that the younger you are, irrespective of these test results, you should still have good success because you have good quality eggs. So until next time, this is Dr. Mark Trolice of Fertility CARE, the IVF Center here in Orlando. Looking forward to speaking with you all again soon.